It's Dr. Robert Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning.
Hey, good morning.
So we've reported that what's driving this seems to be younger people. Is this because bars are open? What is driving this?
Well, what's driving it is who is ever getting infected is not following the rules. They're not wearing masks and they're not practicing social distancing. And yes, the average age of the people getting infected is much lower. And the overall epidemic has gotten much better controlled in places like nursing homes and the jails and places, communal living places. So it's just flipped down into the younger population. This virus doesn't care, it has no brain, it'll affect anybody. But the problem with the younger people, even though they handle the infection better, is they spread it to other people, including their parents and older people.
We saw numbers on the rise again here in Illinois yesterday. I think a lot of people concerned, oh my gosh, are we going to lock down like we did in the spring? Dr. Fauci was saying he doesn't think we need a lockdown again. What are your thoughts?
Well, you know, the whole pandemic in the United States is behaving very different from a regional place. Remember, just a couple weeks ago, we were talking about how bad it was in Arizona. You know, they were having 4,000 new cases per day. Within a very short period of time, they're down to 2,000. So that you can have these really dramatic effects just putting in simple public health control measures. So I think Dr. Fauci is just encouraging all of us just to follow the basic rules and how to control this thing.
There's a projection of 300,000 deaths by December. Now, I remember in the beginning of all this, a projection of 2 million deaths, and I know we're not even at halftime on this thing, but what is your take on how we're doing and that number?
Well, it looks like the 2 million is if we did nothing.
Nothing, okay.
So we are doing something, and some places are doing something better than other places. Like the East Coast now, up at Northeast Coast, is doing very well. Massachusetts, Connecticut, New York State, you know, they've basically got it under control, and they're much more restrictive than we are here in Illinois. So we have to tighten up. We're going in the wrong direction. We're sliding towards what Arizona was happening in Arizona. We're not there yet, not as bad as what they happened, but it has got to turn around here.
What about these COVID tests? Some are saying that even a not so good test is better than what we have. I'm confused. Are some of the tests not accurate?
Well, okay. Not all tests are the same.
Right.
And some are what we say not as sensitive. Maybe they'll get 80% or 90% of all they'll make 80 to 90% of all the diagnoses, but you get the result in 15 minutes. So, what is the difference from a public health standpoint if you take the really good, expensive test and you get the result 14 days later? You know what? That's worthless. No sense. So whereas if you got 80% of the people in 15 minutes, you know, if something goes wrong, you can do another test.
I see.
You can repeat it. So from a public health perspective, those tests, even though they're not as sensitive, they really can help, especially in a situation like this.
All right, let's take a look at some viewer questions. Is it still necessary to disinfect all groceries purchases before bringing into the home?
Well, you know, disinfect, it depends what you're doing disinfecting. Just use common sense. Things that you picked up in the grocery store, if you just can wipe them down with a little soapy water or something, that's all you really need to do. You don't have to go crazy with it.
All right, another question. As for so many, I haven't seen any friends for months. I live in Chicago. Is it all right to meet them for lunch or dinner? Two are from Wisconsin.
Well, it depends when they came from Wisconsin. If they've come here just like recently, Wisconsin, you're supposed to be quarantined for 14 days or you have to get a test after you get here. So yeah, I'd be careful with them. But, you know, they have to now start being careful with us. So, you know, it's just anybody moving around. If you do, yes, you can have lunch with them. You have to eat outdoors and you have to stay 6 feet away from them. You know, as long as you have a good voice and everything and can talk the length of a picnic table, you'll be fine. So it can be done and it can be done safely.
All right. Next question. My husband is attending a golf outing with 65 of his closest friends. The dinner will be served outside. Should he quarantine from me for 14 days after?
Yeah, he can do. Yes, unfortunately, 65 friends is from who knows where they're from and stuff. It's a risky situation. This is why the pandemic is spreading now here in Illinois and many other places. So, yeah, if he does it, you got to stay away from him for 2 weeks. Whether that's good or bad, I don't know.
Maybe that's what she wants, yeah.
Maybe that's what she wants. Hey, yeah. Get away from me, 14 days.
Yeah, hey, you know, we have the viewers.
He could go get one of those tests.
Yeah.
One of those quick tests after 3 days.
All right. Here's a lighthearted question from a viewer, Doctor. With fall coming, are you concerned about a Dr. Murphy Halloween costume epidemic?
Oh.
It could go pandemic. See, you're a trendsetter now.
Yeah, with my shirt and tie and, yeah.
The white head earphones, put you in a little cardboard TV.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. You know, Dr. Fauci has the bobblehead and the donuts and everything. You know.
Yeah.
We're going to start a trend here. All right, if you have a question for the doctor, head to our Morning News Facebook page. You can post it there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. You have a good weekend.
Thanks, doctor.
Have a great weekend.
You too.
Hey, Paul.